And today we honor and give thanks for a man who knew that everything worth striving for, every dream we pursue, every adventure that beckons, and every challenge that calls forth our greatest efforts cannot be accomplished alone. Why did you walk away from the public adulation? He was asked in more ways than we can count. Why didn't you bask in the limelight as long as you could? Because, he said, I didn't deserve it. And I'm convinced that wasn't simply an expression of good Midwestern modesty, an attempt to minimize his own passionate ambition, his commitment to disciplined, hard work, rigorous intellectual study and physical training, and an overwhelming sense of awe and possibility of what one person can, in fact, accomplish. He knew all that. But he spoke the truth. No one goes to the moon alone. No one accomplishes anything of lasting value in any human endeavor alone. Neil Armstrong wanted us to know that. It wasn't about him. As others have said, it was about all of us. It's been said that each person has in our life, we can hope this is true, that each one of us gets one moment of insight, our burning bush, if you will, an otherworldly, time-stopping experience that somehow succeeds in getting through to us, the insight that if we let it, will carry us through and set the course of our life. And in reading the many public tributes to Neil Armstrong, it's obvious that we all assume that the defining moment of his life was those amazing 2.5 hours on the moon. How could it be otherwise? It was, after all, a first, a giant step. But we know well that he tended to downplay the impact of that experience. Once, when he was speaking to a group of students and he was asked, perhaps for the millionth time, how walking on the moon changed his life, he replied that because of walking on the moon, he got to go to a lot more press conferences at which people asked him how the moon changed his life. But then he went on to say, never to miss an opportunity, he went on to say that when he was a kid, about the same age as the students asking those questions, no one had ever flown a plane at supersonic speed. There was no space program. Going to the moon was pure science fiction. In the first half of his lifetime, everything changed. And he said to them, opportunities will be available to you that you cannot imagine. Now, last week in this cathedral, Mr. Vance Wilson, who's the headmaster of St. Albans School, one of the schools of this cathedral, addressed the students, all boys, in their opening chapel. And he drew their attention, as one of the other speakers did, to the beautiful stained glass window on the south side of the chancel that's known as the space window. And at its center is a rock from the moon presented to the cathedral by the three men of Apollo 11, one of whom, Mr. Collins, who graces us here with his presence, is, I might add, a St. Albans graduate, class of 1948. Mr. Wilson also mentioned, in a way that would have pleased Neil Armstrong to no end, he mentioned NASA's historic landing of Curiosity on Mars this summer and the endlessly fascinating stream of photographs available to us now on our computers. Gentlemen, Mr. Wilson said, how about beginning this school year with a dream? Ever thought about being the first human being to walk on Mars? Why not? You wouldn't be the first St. Albans graduate to do the impossible. You better get started, though. If you leave today, it'll take you the entire school year to get there. And so, without question, walking on the moon confirmed for Neil Armstrong the importance of a dream, a compelling vision that propels us as individuals and a nation and a species where we've never been. And it pleased him whenever his examples and the words of his family inspired young people around the world to work hard to make their dreams come true, to be willing to explore and push the limits, and to selflessly serve a cause greater than themselves. And that cause, I suggest to you, for Mr. Armstrong, was not exploration for exploration's sake, but for the survival of the only planet we human beings call home.